Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to study economics, the remaining part of the story of Palampur. Here we are going to study a new topic, that is about production. As you know that production means producing something from some inputs. So production is to produce the goods and services that we want. People want many things to produce, that is known as production. And there are four requirements for the production. There are basically four requirements for the production. What are they? The first one is known as land. Land is the very important requirement for the production. And land include water, forest, mineral, etc. These all we get from the land. So land, from land we get many things, that is water, forest, minerals, etc. So the first important requirement for the production is known as, what is that? Land. Second important requirement for production is known as labor. Labor means the work which is done by the people, or people who will do the work, that is labor. So labor is the next important requirement for the production. And you know that people who will do the work, they are different. Some people who are very educated, their knowledge and skill is required. So people who are educated, very highly educated, their knowledge, skill are required for the production. Whereas some people who are workers, they do manual work. Their work is also equally important for the production. So some manual work is very important, and some people who are highly educated, their knowledge and skill are also needed for the production. So land, after land, next important factor of production required, that is known as labor. Third important factor of production we need, that is known as physical capital. Physical capital, in the sense, it includes two types of capitals. One is known as fixed capital, other one is known as working capital. So physical capital include two important capital, that is fixed capital and working capital. Fixed capital in the sense, tools, machines, buildings, etc. So fixed capital means tools, machines, buildings, etc. And next about fixed capital, another important thing I want to say, that it can be used over many years. If we take about tools, after one round of production, we can use the tools again for another round of production. Machines, same way, one round of production is completed, again we can use that machines for the another round of production. Buildings, same building we can produce many things. So buildings, machines, tools, which can be used over many years, which is considered as fixed capital. It do not exhaust during production. And fixed capital, as we say, it do not exhaust after the or during the production. So we say that fixed capital. So fixed assets or fixed capital, building, tools, machines, these all are included in the fixed capital, which do not exhaust or which do not used up during the production. And next important type of capital we take, that is known as working capital. So working capital is also included in physical capital. I have told you that physical capital, which include two type of capital, fixed capital and working capital. Working capital is known as another important capital, which is in the physical capital, Working capital means raw materials and money in the hand. Raw materials which are necessary for the production. Money is also very important for production because money is required in different stages of production. So raw material and money, which are known as working capital. For example, if we take yarn used by weaver is a raw material, yarn. Clay is another raw material which is used by the potter. This is also working capital. These yarn or clay, after one round of production, it is used up. So these materials or raw materials are used up during production. So it is known as working capital. Just like fixed capital, it cannot be used again and again. Once it is used, it exhausts or it is used up in the production. So money is one of the working capital. Next important capital, as we all know, that is known as human capital. Human capital in the sense, the human being, human resource, people. These all we can say that human capital. As we know that human resource, last year you have learned in geography human resource. So human resource or people, they are very important for production. So it is known as human capital because human resource, people with high education and health, good health, they become one of the asset or one of the important capital or one of the important requirement for the production. As human beings with high education and health, they become the human capital. So human capital is very important. We can see in the picture human capital. So this is another important factor which is required for the production. Now we can study. So I have told you that physical capital, which includes two types of capital, which are they? Physical capital includes fixed capital, which includes tools, machines, buildings. It can be used over many years. It do not exhaust during the production. While working capital is another important physical capital, second type of physical capital, raw material and money in hand are working capital. For example, yarn used by weaver, clay used by potter, these are working capital. But the thing is that these are used, once it is used, it exhausts, means it is used up in during the production. Next thing, we have to study a definition which is about the factors of production. What do you mean by factors of production, or we say define factors of production? We can define factors of production as below. Every production is organized by combining land, labor, physical capital and human capital. So every production which is organized by combining land, labor, physical capital, which includes two types of capital, fixed capital and working capital, and also human capital, which are known as factors of production. This is the definition that you have to study. So we have analyzed today, that is, there are many types of factors of production. As we know, four important: land, then labor, physical capital, which include fixed capital, working capital, and these are the main four factors of production, as we say. And along with that, human capital is also very essential for the production. And the production means the producing something, producing goods and services that we want. So for every production, these all factors are very much essential.